Salman wept in my court, you know, session court, when that 5-year imprisonment was given out, he started crying. And I smiled and I said, ye real ka hero hai, real life ke hero hum hai. You know, when I think why I changed my path, I mean, civil services, half of you must have thought, why should I not take the IAS exam? And even today, almost 10 lakh students every year are taking that exam. But somehow, when everything that glitters is not gold, I was brought up with values, principles. I was told, come what may, you will not give up. That's what my mom taught me. And dad said, go out and fight. Let this world know that here is a woman of steel. So that was the reason I did law from Bombay University. And that too, after being in the government for almost 14 years, I had 2 children. And I was seeing the rampant corruption in every organization. And I said, people were keeping quiet. People didn't want to knock the courts because they felt nobody would listen to them. And that was the reason. And I think this should be something for all of you, that it is never too late. The day you feel within you that, yes, I want to do different, I want to be different, and I want to do something for the society. And all of us, in our little way, can make a change. We all are change makers. It's only that we don't want to come out of the comfort zone. In the corporate world, even today, there is a salary difference of almost 20%. And these are studies which have been conducted by World Economic Forum. In fact, you were talking of happiness. And I would like to tell you that India has slipped 8 ranks. From 133, we are 140 in the happiness index. That means we've gone down. And the reasons they've taken, the study was on equality. It was on justice. There is no equality. The rural labor, if you compare a female labor to a male labor, a woman, female gets around 258 and the man gets 359 rupees. I mean, at that level. You come to the higher level, there also there is a 30% gap, wage gap. So is that equality? I mean, if we don't even get equal salaries for the work done, even though we are more qualified, this shows that our very fundamental rights are violated. When the Constitution gives us Article 14, equality before law, equal protection of laws. Article 19 gives us equality of opportunity in employment. So when the salaries are not equal, we are not at all equal. So I think today you must go back and think that where we are lagging, why the government has not come forward and made a law. 39D is still a directive principle of state policy, which says there should be equal pay for equal work. But it has not been executed. There is no law to back it. Only in the government, I can say, I mean, I was better off in the government where the salaries were equal. If you're in the IAS, be it a female or a male, you will get the same salary. But you go to the legal world. Supreme Court for the first time has 3 women judges. Otherwise, it was just 1. Senior counsels, you can count on your fingers. It is the same situation everywhere. So if we want equality, we have to fight for it. In fact, the women reservation bill, 5 times it has come in the parliament, but the men refused to give us what was due to us. And they came on our appearances. They said, oh, you are going to have these women with short hair talk in the parliament. They are going to run the country. It just showed the patriarchal mindset, the regressive mindset. And we have kept quiet. I think 2019 elections is round the corner. Whoever comes to ask for a vote, you ask him, what have you done for us? Have you given us our dues? Will you get a law for equal pay? This would come in, I don't know who's going to be your MP from this area, but whoever comes, you must ask. And all of you are powerful. Why should it only be Abha Singh who goes to the High Court? Yesterday I was filing a PIL and I was in the court for right to dissent. And that is what I will share with you. After the little 8-year-old girl who was raped in Jammu Kashmir, we did an agitation at Carter Road. It was on 15th April. And we said we are going to agitate and we want to give a voice to the increasing crime against women. The police said, you will do it without a loudspeaker. since we wanted to do it, we did it, but because there was no loudspeaker, the voice just died down. After 15 days, women wanted to do a protest march at Marine Drive. There also the police said, you will not use a mic loudspeaker and you will only walk in threes. You will not take out a procession. I told the High Court yesterday, Chief Justice Court, I was there, and I said, even for independence, we could use the loudspeakers. Under the British, there were no ban like this, that you can't use a loudspeaker if you want to protest. You mean to say a handful of women are going to create a law and order? The police said section 144. 144 means more than 5 people cannot collect at a time. So, situation is so bad in this country that on Carter Road and Marine Drive, you have section 144, 365 days of the year. You know, so what I'm trying to say, yesterday when I told the Chief Justice, he says, you want to appear in person? I said, yes, because I felt that today if I don't raise my voice, tomorrow if something happens, I cannot even come out and speak, because you will make Maharashtra a police state. The new section which came, section 37, which says you have to fill a form in the office of the police station, and that you have to say if you're going to use a loudspeaker, what you're going to do, only then police gives you permission. Mind you, this was not there at the time of independence. This section 37 was inserted much later by Bombay police, and we have kept quiet. So what I want to say, be aware, stand up for your rights, and if you feel you have to walk the last mile, go ahead. You are not doing it just for yourself. You are doing it for your future. You are doing it for your nation. You are doing it for the country. And I personally never, I feel that I am abla nari. Please, I never feel that. I came from Lucknow, married at a young age, took the civil services later, but my passion and my commitment and my conviction takes me forward. And that is what I want to tell every one of us here, that if you are passionate, if you are committed, nothing can stop you. And that is why, even when I went to Columbia University this year to speak on Me Too, and it was an economic summit where you had the World Bank and the IMF, and they said, why Me Too? I said, what can you talk of an economy and growth if you are not protecting the women at the workplace? And posh is just an eyewash. In the corporate field, you have that law, sexual harassment at workplace. Recently, I'm handling a matter where the woman who was heading the posh committee has been terminated because she had the courage and the gumption to come forward and take action against the person who was sexually harassing women. But he was the blue-eyed of the corporate club. So I'm saying, how do you have a posh committee where you don't protect the ICC members? So there are so many things we need to work on. And bust, you know, gender parity, I was just reading why. A woman who does not get adequate salary suffers domestic violence because she continues to live in her husband's house. Why? Because she doesn't have that extra money needed to pay rent. She doesn't have a place to go to. So don't go by that. And there is a study by University of Bath which says women underestimate themselves, and they are happy about it that they are getting less salary. The economists are trying to study on this paradox, that why they are getting less salary, they underestimate themselves, and yet they are happy. I think that mindset needs to change. And you all, I'm happy that there are more girls here, everyone, I mean just two or three people, men, but you girls, please change your mindset. You are not second best, you are the best. But till the time you feel that, you will be treated second best in your life. So when I am in the court, I say, "Main, I will send the best bugger to jail if he messes up with me." So that's it. Thank you so much.